The campaigns tool inside of HubSpot is an awesome tool, but it hasn't always been easy to get a list of the contacts involved in campaigns, until now.
Welcome to HubSpot Hacks, where we help you get more out of HubSpot.
If you're like most people using the campaigns tool inside of HubSpot, you really appreciate those analytics they provide. But it hasn't always been easy to get a list of the contacts that have been involved in that campaign. So we're gonna dive in and show you just how to do that. So this here is a list of all the campaigns we have. We're gonna go into this AMA Madness campaign, a real small campaign we ran. And you can see at the top here, it'll show you how many contacts have been involved in this campaign. So you can see that there's been 3 contacts that were created as a result of this campaign, 6 contacts that were influenced. And if you click on this number, you can get a list of the contacts involved. But this isn't the same as the other list that you're familiar with in HubSpot that you can do things like create custom CRM views with or send emails to those lists. So they give you the option to use this button at the bottom that says use in a list, and that'll create a list of these contacts. So it sounds pretty simple, right? So let's do that and see what it looks like. I'm just gonna name this list test for now and hit add to list. And then it'll give you a link here. So we're gonna look at that. All right, so you can see that we've got the 3 contacts that we just saw in the list. Pretty straightforward. The problem is that this is a static list. So as more contacts get added to the campaign or get involved with the campaign, this list doesn't update. You've got to keep going in there manually and creating this list. So if your campaign's over, that method works really well. But if you're in the middle of a campaign or your campaign is like a long running or evergreen campaign, it's not super easy. So there is a way to do it, and I'm gonna show you how. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go back to all of our lists and click this create list button. We're gonna select contact properties. We want this to be an active list because we want this to update. So we're gonna go contact properties. We're gonna search for campaign here. So it gives us 3 different options with campaigns. We get this last touch converting campaign and first touch converting campaign. Really depends on what data you want in this list for which option you're gonna choose here. The first touch converting campaign is just like it sounds. The first time a contact interacted with your website or any emails, that web page or email or landing page, whatever they interacted with, the first time is associated with the campaign that we're gonna choose. The last touch converting campaign is a little bit more confusing. It doesn't mean the most recent thing they interacted with was in that campaign. It means the last thing they interacted with before they actually converted to being a contact. So it could be a form that they filled out, the last page that form was on, or something like that. So for most of the time, you're probably gonna wanna have both of these options selected. And essentially what that's gonna do is give you a list of the people that were created as a result of the campaign. Unfortunately, there's no way to do an active list of everybody that was influenced with the campaign. So if they were already a contact and then touched a campaign asset, there's no way to do that. You'll have to use that static list option that we already showed you. But for contacts being created as a result of a campaign, you can use these options. So let's start with this first touch converting campaign. This is where things get a little bit confusing. You would expect to see a drop-down list here of all of your campaigns. But unfortunately, you can't do that. So the next thing you're probably going to try is to type in the name of the campaign. Unfortunately, that doesn't work either. What you have to have is you have to have the unique identifier that HubSpot has associated with that campaign. And it's not super easy to go find that, but I'll show you where it's at. So we're gonna jump back to our campaigns here, exit out of this. So anytime you're in a campaign, so we're in a campaign view here, you can see that our URL has this string after that last slash. That's a bunch of letters and numbers. This here, everything after this last slash, is your unique identifier for this campaign. So I'm gonna copy that, come back over here, and I'm just gonna paste it into this text field. And now what we're gonna see, it's gonna take a few minutes, but we're gonna see those same 3 contacts that we're seeing right here. But the difference is, as more contacts get added as a result of the campaign, they'll automatically be added to this list. The option that we showed you earlier with that static list, they won't be added. You'll keep having to go back and click that button. So I'm gonna apply this filter. And now anytime a contact touches, if their first touch is a part of this campaign and then they become a contact, they'll be added to this list. I also want to know if somebody has been, maybe they've been visiting our website or something like that, but they haven't become a contact yet, but the last thing they touch before becoming a contact is also part of this campaign. I also want them on this list. So I'm gonna hit this OR button, go contact properties again, search campaign, and I'm gonna add this last touch, and I'm just gonna enter that same unique identifier, apply filter, and you see it adds one more person here. So this here will only show you those first touch contacts. So if you want a little bit more data, if you want those last touch contacts, this is also a great way to get that. So now I've got this, I'm gonna name this one test two. I'm gonna save it. And now I've got this list that I can use again for emails. I can create custom CRM views. I can do some reporting with it. So whatever you need to do with this list of contacts, now you can do it, because when I go back to my lists, it's right here. It's processing, so that's why it still says zero. But once it's done processing, it'll show those four contacts that are in it. And now you can use it for whatever you want. So that's all there is to it. Really not intuitive at all, but really simple once you know how to do it. So make sure you hit that subscribe button for more HubSpot hacks, how-tos, and tips. And if there's any questions you have on this or things you want us to cover in the future, go ahead and drop them in those comments below.